Welcome back to another Solopress tutorial. Let's take a look at clipping masks in Photoshop. Before I go into clipping masks, it's worth noting this isn't the same as layer masks in Photoshop. Layer masks is this little icon here, and it's typically used for removing an object from its background. I'm going to do a tutorial about a layer mask very soon, so if you don't want to miss it, feel free to subscribe. For clipping masks, there are two typical uses. The most commonly used one is if you want an image to appear in something, for example, like this text. So I want this surfer image to appear within this text. So all you have to do, and this goes against, if like me, you use Illustrator a lot and you have, you're using masks, you would typically have that image of that text above the image. For clipping masks in Photoshop, it's the other way around, so it might take a bit of adjustment. But what you have to do is have the photo on top of the image you want it clipped to, and then right click and create clipping mask. And there you go, it's done. And you, with that layer selected, the surfer, I can move the image around to where I want it and scale it, whatever you want to do. And equally, I can get hold of that text and move it. If you get it in a position where you're happy, you can link the two files to avoid that happening. So press shift and select both layers. Click this little chain to link them, and then you can move them together. Another thing worth noting is clipping masks will always apply to wherever there's an occupied pixel in the layer below it. So let me just explain that. So if, for example, on this surf text, if I were to erase some of that with a soft brush, the clipping mask will be loyal to what the opacity. So if I erase that background, you can see some of these pixels are more opaque than others and they've been blended out. The clipping mask will be loyal to that. So now I'm going to apply the same rules of clipping masks but to this TV image. So what I'm going to do, I want our surfer here to appear within the screen. So what I've done, I've cut that screen out using a pen tool. If you want to learn how to use the pen tool, have a look at our last tutorial. I did pen tool in Illustrator, but it works exactly the same in Photoshop. So what I've done, I've cut that screen out, and that's what I want to, my shape for my clipping mask, and I want to put my surfer in there. Okay, so right click on my surfer, create clipping mask, and there we go. It's in, and I can move it around. And now, this is the other part of clipping masks that's so great. You can stack clipping masks and add textures, adjustment layers. So for above this one, I've got a little TV texture here, like a kind of interference. And you can see at the moment, it needs to be clipped. So I'm gonna right click, create clipping mask. And there you go, it's in the TV screen. And you can see it's all applying to what this layer below that's underlined. And I can stack them up and I could add, for example, let's add a vibrancy adjustment layer and let's crank up the vibrancy there. Saturation, let's go nuts. Okay. And then what we'll do, let's just shut this. And then what you can do, at the moment you can see that's affected the whole image. So the vibrancy has gone crazy on this, on the telly. And that's a perfect example of why you want a clipping mask. So by right clicking, create clipping mask, and it maintains it within that shape now. So you can see they're all stacked up above this layer that's underlined, clipping mask, clipping mask, clipping mask, and that really is the main way you want to use clipping masks. Hope that's helped. Let me know any comments below and I'll get back to you, and we'll see you again for the next one. Take care.